Today is January 5th, 2023. This is 184th episode for C++17 2023 Coda SQL OpenGL OpenCL TBB Vulkan. This is 14th episode for vector calculus. We will implement curvature 1. Curvature 1 means that I will create one or more videos about curvature. This is Motions in Space 2 episode. To follow my current session, you need updated C++ library extensions. Before filming this video, you can click this link to download updated C++ library extensions. After filming this video, you can double-click this link to download updated C++ library extensions. From my YouTube channel, C++17 2023 CUDA SQL from this playlist. If you scroll down from this playlist, select episode 182. From episode 182, show more, download current video source code. Click this link. Show in folder, unzip it, rename 184, copy, paste in your working directory. Open up Visual Studio Code, CPP17 2023. From folder 184, double click Lambda, Ctrl B, Ctrl Home. If you haven't watched my previous video, please watch them. These two videos will be very useful. I will fold it up. Right click CPG Calculus. Go to Definition. Ctrl End. If you scroll up, you can find the torsion. From this book, Thomas's Calculus Early Transcendentals, 13th edition. Chapter 13.5 Tangential and Normal Components of Acceleration. If you scroll down, in page 782, vector formula for curvature. We will use this formula to implement curvature. We need to compute velocity and acceleration. Then we do cross product. Then we take magnitude. Also, from velocity, we take magnitude cube. I will copy this part. Paste it here. We are implementing Thomas Calculus 13th edition, chapter 13.5, vector formula for curvature, page 782. The function name will be curvature. We differentiate position vector r once, first order derivative, so it is velocity. We differentiate position vector twice, or second order derivative. It represents acceleration. We don't need third order derivative. So it becomes V cross A. I will delete this part. Auto magnitude V cross A, V cross A magnitude. We need auto V magnitude cube. R1 represent velocity. From velocity, we take magnitude cube. Then we can return by capturing magnitude B cross product A, B magnitude cube. We take SED floating point auto T. We can return floating point auto. Don't miss semicolon. Return magnitude V cross A. We pass T over magnitude cube T. So this formula implements Vector formula for curvature. We will implement one more. I will copy this part. Paste it here. I will rename vector formula. In this book again, at page 773, you can find another formula. Now, we will implement curvature using this formula. I will paste this text. So, implementing curvature using unit tangent vector. Curvature with unit tangent. We still need velocity. Although R1, this is velocity. This derivative, first order, we can pass stencil kind. We call member function derivative. It returns velocity. Although V mag R1 magnitude. Magnitude of velocity vector or speed. I will create another function or ut mag. We will capture a copy of this SED floating point or t. We can return floating point or. Don't miss semicolon. Or ut this unit tangent. Ut stands for unit tangent vector. Or dt mag from unit tangent vector. We differentiate derivative first order derivative. We are taking derivative of unit tangent vector. We pass stencil here. Please understand, we are in template function. In template function, when the member is template, in this case, we need to use template. We have taken derivative of unit tangent vector. I say ut dt. We have taken derivative of unit tangent vector. Derivative of unit tangent vector. Then or ut dt magnitude. You can say ut dt magnitude. We are basically computing dt over dt. We acquired unit tangent vector t. Then we differentiated our unit tangent vector. Then we take magnitude. Then return ut dt mag bypassing t. Now here return we capture velocity magnitude. Also unit tangent magnitude. SED floating point or t. We actually don't need this, but I will use it. Don't miss semicolon. We now return unit tangent derivative magnitude bypassing t. then B make T. So we implemented this formula. This formula. I filmed this part of video on 5th of January. Today is 6th of January. It is 6:31 a.m. I made a mistake here. Also, I made a mistake here. Now fixed. In this file, I will arrange side by side like this. I will copy this part and paste it here. Test curvature 1. Copy this function name, control end, paste it here, disable it. In this book, from chapter 13.5, scroll down. In the exercise 13.5, we will solve problem 27. This problem here, this is square root 3, as in this document T is square root 3. I will copy and paste this part. CNA BCTR 3D R. R is position vector. Don't miss semicolon. OROT return. We return this part. T times SED cosine T. Copy, paste. We implement this part. Sine T. Copy, paste. We implement this part. T. Remove trailing comma. So we implemented this position vector. Now OROT SED square root 3 this part. Then ORO curvature 1 CNA we are calling this function I dismember ORO K2. Sorry, we don't need the CNA. R, then this formula. STD, CL, K1, T, K1, T, CPG, and there. Copy, paste, K2, K2. So we are calling this function from function main. You can open any compiler. CD 184 curvature. Clang plus plus. SED C plus plus 20 lambda dot CPP LTBB 12 OC dot exe. Hit enter. CLSC. So we have this result. In this book, answer sheet. Solution 13.5. Problem 27. We have computed curvature 0.5060, 0.5059. This is approximate value. This is approximate value. So our result matches with this book.